They're four games each, winning two on the road. Stockton controlling the opening chip. He's guarded here at the start by Findlay.
Just limit your mistakes, and that's what Don Nelson told his team yesterday.
Olden Collinis getting the first field goal of the game. Juan Howard, and here's Nash for three. Yes, Steve Nash. And what a difference as Malone is able to beat Howard. What a difference in terms of experience. The steal by Russell. Bradley able to get it. A little ball fake by Sean Bradley. And here's Nash with the runner. Bradley on the tip.
How about the energy in this building? A frenetic pace. And
these days is coming off the bench.
Well, he has not taken two good shots here to start the game. Now there's two layups by Karl Malone. That changes the whole game. Now he's
ball. Foul was called on John Stockton. Dirk Nowitzki has a terrific first step, able to whip by Danielle Marshall.
Basket right there. Russell really trying to get going here. He needs a layup, and he's going to get it right here, Marv, after missing his first four shots.
Ryan, we're talking about why the problems at home. Nowitzki on the break. Utah in possession, up by one. Pretty pass. Stockton to the ball.
He makes the game look so easy, but the relentless running of Karl Malone.
8-0 run for Utah. Nash, well, they lied about he took the technical foul shot. John Starks. He hit the three with 2.9 seconds remaining in regulation. Game two coming up Tuesday in Philly. Here's Russell from downtown. And after one here at the Delta Center in Salt Lake, it's the Jazz 22 and the Mavericks 17. You're watching the NBA on NBC. Manning thought he had Ostertag. Nowitzki handles the ball so well for a guy 6'11", and a beautiful pass to Findlay.
A little slow release by Russell as he tried to dunk it. Bradley comes from behind. He's got to get that shot off sooner.
Nowitzki from downtown on a quick release. So Nowitzki has seven, and the Mavs again are within one. Malone lost it. Mark Bryant, who just checked in, able to get a piece of it. And here's Nowitzki with Ostertag back. This should be interesting. Now Nowitzki on the pull-up. And Dallas has taken a one-point lead.
How about the skill level? Dirk Nowitzki.
Now joined by the owner of the Dallas Mavericks, Mark Cuban. Mark, let me ask you if I can. You have had a running battle all year long with Karl Malone back and forth in the press. What is your problem? What does you have against Karl Malone?
No real problem. He's the greatest power forward ever to play the game. I just don't think it's right when you intentionally try to take a guy out of the game and injure him. And, you know, but the league dealt with it, and so it's all behind us. It's been a clean game so far, so all is good.
This team has turned around very quickly under your stewardship. Are you surprised at how quickly and how well the Mavs have done so quickly?
You know, I really didn't know what to expect. When you have a guy like Michael Findlay, Steve Nash, Dirk Nowitzki, they put their heart and soul into the game. They put their heart and soul into the game, and so I knew good things could happen. We just had to put them in a position to succeed. And so
I agree with you. I did the Olympics. I saw him play, and he came right into camp and picked up, and right on cue drives right to the basket for a layup.
Gorgeous move. Here's Stockton with the look away to Marshall. Bradley got a piece of it. And back come the Mavs. It's a 4-on-1. Findlay to Howard.
Utah better be very careful. Dallas is seducing him into the game. They want to play right now. And
Manning. Danny Manning getting inside, making 8 assists for John Stockton.
I watched him that whole possession. Stockton had the ball. He gave it up. He looked at the shot clock. He got it back. He looked at the shot clock, and a gorgeous pass for a layup. They're going for a quick 2-for-1 possession.
Manning, yes. Utah recaptures the lead. They're up by one. 8 unanswered for the Jazz.
Well, that's why they...
Utah with an 8-0 run the last 2 minutes and 15 seconds. And they're up by one at halftime.
Well, that's what you do. You turn up the defense. Utah did it. That big surge at the end of the half. They have to feel very good now as they've been able to get the momentum back.
Game two Tuesday night here at the Delta Center. Nice pass again.
That's unfair for a guy to be able to make that kind of pass with this kind of pressure.
And Joe Crawford telling Don Nelson to sit down.
Don Nelson better be very careful. I'm going to get ejected in a moment like this. He got one just like father, like son. They both got tees on that play. There's Donnie Nelson right there. He gets the tee. Papa Don gets one also, so two technical fouls. And
all right, Jim, here's Karl Malone. Stockton keeps it alive. Marshall! Finley is open for three.
Yes, that's the guy that's got to bring him back.
Defensively, Nowitzki going up against the center. Oops, the tag, and then is able to fire from downtown to tie the game at 58. Isley with the fadeaway. Nowitzki on the tip, and the Mavs lead by one. Seven. And after three in this game, one of the best of five, it's the Mavericks 62, the Jazz 61. We'll be back after these words from your local station. You are watching the NBA playoffs on NBC.
Offensive rebounds once again.
Beautiful pass, Stockton to Marshall. Stockton with his 13th assist.
I can't imagine as a shooter playing with this guy. You would have.
Nowitzki for three. Stockton for Russell. Oh, what a play.
Have you ever seen Stockton better than he's been today?
The 39-year-old John Stockton has taken over this ballgame. 14 assists for Stockton. And think about that for a moment. Here's a guy who scored only 4 points, but it's his game here.
When he's been out of the game, they've been totally out of sync.
Finley, beautiful move. He's averaged just under 9 assists per game this past regular season, finishing second to Jason Kidd. Stockton hits the jump shot. Trying to draw the foul. Now Finley for three. Yes.
Oh, that.
Nowitzki with the rebound and able to recover. Technical foul on Don Nelson, so he has been ejected. And once again, assistant coach Del Harris stepping in front of Don Nelson to restrain him. That's his second technical. Earlier, both Don and his son were hit with tees. Joe Crawford tossing Don Nelson, and John Stockton will shoot the tee.
Say, that's really costly. You lose your coach, number one, but...
Karl Malone is now 5 for 19. Meanwhile, the Mavericks continue to roll. That's 23 for Finley. They've taken a 1-point lead. They continue to go to Malone, and he draws the foul. Oh, Mark Bryant having some words with Karl Malone. And a technical foul was called on Bryant. Malone continues to shoot, and this time able to hit.
Great players must keep doing that.
Stockton with 15 assists. Malone, yes. That equals his season high. Nowitzki taking the shot. It counts. And the foul.
What a game. Everything we thought it was going to be, Marv. Both.
All over the court, Dirk Nowitzki and Michael Finley have each gone the distance. They played all the way. Finley for three. He is 4 for 7 from downtown, and the Mavericks are up by four.
And after eight.
To break up that back door to give the ball back to Dallas. Here's Nash. What a move by Steve Nash going to the reverse. He has 18, and it's Dallas by 6. Stockton on the reverse finds Marshall. Yes. Donnell. Shot clock down to 5. Offensive foul called on Nash. Stockton for 3. Stockton on the recovery. Stockton straight down the lane.
I know I sound like a broken record. Offensive rebound.
Just under 2 remaining in the fourth. Nash. Steve Nash taking it to the rim to extend to a 4-point lead. At three at Reunion in Dallas next Saturday afternoon. Beautiful pass, Stockton to Malone.
How'd that get through? How did that get through all of those bodies, and how did he see him?
Malone. Stockton on the rebound. And a loose ball foul is called. And the Mavericks now lead 85-82.
Well, you know right now that in that timeout, Dallas was talking about screen roll. How are we going to defend against it? Because you know it's coming.
Both teams have two full timeouts and they're 20. This is desperation time for Utah. Manning for three. Yes!
Danny Manning, the veteran, cutting it to a 1-point lead. Finley or Nowitzki, who will Dallas go to on this possession?
Finley with 26, 12 coming here in the fourth. Nowitzki with 20, Nash with 20. When they beat the Lakers in the Western Conference Finals, Nowitzki. And Utah on the loose ball with just under a half minute remaining. Stockton accelerates and is fouled by Howard.
John Stockton was watching the whole way. Jerry Sloan, out of the timeout, wanted to go to a high screen roll. He had a broken court ahead of him instead of pulling it back. And that's what you want him to do. Go to the basket, and he makes the two free throws.
Utah by one. Steve Nash checking with Donnie Nelson. 1 second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. You know that Stockton would love to come up with the steal right here. Down to seven. Down to five. Nowitzki lost it. With 3 3/10 seconds remaining of the fourth quarter, the foul against the Mavericks.
And Donnie Nelson is beside himself, running up and down the sideline, the pressure of the moment. Let's watch as Nowitzki takes the ball to the basket. That was a clean strip. Malone got his hand in there and knocked that ball away cleanly. That was a good defensive play, Marv.
Foul was called on Howard on the recovery attempt. Well, Donnie Nelson's dad was ejected earlier. There's Dallas owner Mark Cuban reacting to the call, which will send Danielle Marshall to the line. He's 1 for 1 this afternoon, a 75% free throw shooter. Utah by one. Marshall hits the second. Nowitzki setting it up for Finley for three. The Utah Jazz, in a dramatic finish, have taken game one of this festival. Defeating the Dallas Mavericks 88-86, sparked by the 39-year-old John Stockton, who came up with 18 assists, a season high for Stockton, the all-time NBA playoff record shared by John Stockton.